with the first pick in the 2020 draft, the Cincinnati Bengals select Joe Burrow, quarterback, LSU.
One more ride, one more race, we go all out, we don't play.
One more ride, one more way, we don't slow down, ain't no brakes.
I'ma go off, I'ma ride tonight, it don't matter what we face.
I'ma go off, I'ma ride tonight, I'm the master of my fate.
I'ma go off,
I'ma go off,
I'ma go off,
I'ma go off,
yeah, I gotta go now.
Taking off and I'm riding on the road.
Yo, welcome back, Who Dey Nation, Bengal fans everywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. Today, we have to give the man of the hour his flowers, Joe Mixon. I had to give you all a full video on Joe Mixon. And first and foremost, before I even get started, I'd like to say thank you guys so much for all the love I've been getting. We're at about 245 subscribers on the channel, I believe. And it's a beautiful, beautiful thing to see. The quick growth. We just started the channel about, what, a month and a half, 2 months ago. And already, at I think, like, I got around 15,000 views and all. I mean, it's going crazy. It's going absolutely brazy. Actually, 20,000 closer to. But thank you guys so much. Continue to subscribe and let me know what kind of Bengals content you guys want to see that I'm not giving you, because I'm going to give it to y'all. But anyway, Joe Mixon. Now, before I even get to him, I'd like to say congrats on him for winning AFC Player of the Week. Extremely well-deserved after a stellar performance and a career high in yards against the Steelers. This is the second week in a row that he's come up huge. And with the increase of carries and the way we're winning games lately, the running game is quickly becoming part of the offense's identity. And he has been stellar. But, like I said, before I get in depth about him, shame on me if I do not mention the Bengals O-line. From Reef to Spain to Jonah Williams to Hop, to even backup guys like Isaiah Prince last Sunday. These guys have proven all year long how slept on and unfairly criticized they have been. The fan base has consistently, and I mean for years, just taken a big fat dookie on them, and for good reason. It's not like they've been the best part of the team by any stretch of the imagination, but this year it feels like we've kind of had them in question a little bit more than they should have been if you watch a lot of tape. Because of PFF grades, per se. Even I fall victim to it sometimes, you know. Whenever you see so much going around about, oh, Hopkins has the worst PFF grade in the league, and maybe he wasn't playing the best football of his career. He's coming off an injury, but the offensive line has really been pulling it together, especially these last 2 weeks, and we have to give them a certain percentage of the credit for Joe Mixon's play. So thank you, offensive line. You guys are playing absolutely incredible. Hakeem Adeniji might be the answer at the guard spot. He just might. I mean, he looks like he's an NFL starter from what I've seen. I just saw, if PFF grades is what we're going by, Isaiah Prince just had, what, the fifth best grade on the team this recent week, and he's the backup to Reef. The O-line has just been stepping up when they need to. Hopkins has had a way better last 2 weeks than he did the rest of the season. Jonah Williams is probably the best lineman on the entire team, and Quentin Spain brings an energy to the offensive line that is very needed. So the whole offensive line just been playing stellar football, and I would be remiss not to mention them. But anyway, let's get to Joe. Joe Mixon, coming out of Oklahoma, a first-team All-Big 12 running back, he was an extremely promising young prospect who the majority of the public viewed as a first-round talent, including myself. Due to a rough misdemeanor mistake off the field in college that didn't look good to NFL scouts or fans or anybody, he slid to the Cincinnati Bengals with the 48th overall pick in the 2017 NFL Draft. And from day one, he was productive for the Bengals, finishing his rookie year with 626 rushing yards, 4 touchdowns, 30 receptions, and 287 receiving yards. It was very quickly evident that he would be at the bare minimum at least a solid starting running back in the league. But over time, it became more and more evident that he'd be a star. And fast forward 4 years later, Mixon is among the NFL's best running backs. I mean, the very, very best. Being third in rushing yards behind only Jonathan Taylor and Derrick Henry at the time of this video's recording. And coming off 2 games in which he had 288 yards, 4 rushing touchdowns, a FedEx Ground Player of the Week award, and AFC Player of the Week award over the stretch, it's a perfect time to give Joe his flowers, as what I believe, by the time his tenure here is done, will be considered a Bengal legend, ladies and gentlemen. Joe Mixon, we're going to miss him. We're going to miss him when he's gone, and I'll tell you why. The first thing we have to acknowledge whenever we talk about Joe Mixon is his leadership. And this year, this has been very, very, very much in play. Being that he came into the league with so many character questions and off-the-field concerns, to see him come in and be a plus in the locker room and not a negative and a captain for the offense is awesome. And one thing I, as an observant fan, over the two-game losing or after the two-game losing streak, we went on with New York and Cleveland, I noticed that Mixon was very chin up, progressive thinking, leader-like, very, very, very much so looking forward to showing what kind of team they really are in the press conference. He was very, very, he didn't hang his head at all. It was very, I mean, you know, he's a leader. He's a leader. He's a captain for a reason this year. I know partially it's because Giovanni Bernard is no longer a Bengal, so it kind of gave him a perfect opportunity to just slide in right there, running back captain, running back captain, but... He's been arguably, other than Joe Burrow, the biggest leader for this offense this season. But anyways, moving on. I won't move on, actually, because we have to really harp on leadership. We have to harp on this leadership. This is very important. Zach Taylor harps on it all the time, knowing how great it is to see young dogs. Young dogs. I'm talking like Joe Mixon's a dog on the field. He's not like... You know, he's not a guy that doesn't match his performance with the leadership. But to see young dogs with that knack for not getting too low with a loss or too high with a win, Joe has proved to be that this year. Also being part of that three-person presser statement with Bates and Boyd. So, I mean, there's so many examples you can use of Joe Mixon as a leader to just appreciate as a Bengals fan, because it's not like we're always going to have this here, guys. This is he's a different kind of leader. He's an energetic. He enlightens the entire locker room, and we have many guys on the team like that right now, but not many guys on the team like that are performing to his level right now. He is at the top of his position right now, so it's very important that we talk about it and appreciate it for what it is while it's here. But being this plus I speak of in regards to leadership, it also kind of links. It kind of leaks into the next thing that makes Mixon so great for this team: the energy, the swag, the flex of all of it. Joe Mixon is arguably the best touchdown dancer in football, and I stand on that. I stand on that with all 10 toes. He has something ready at all times, and it lights not only the fan base up, but the entire team, from the coaches to the front office to the goddamn players on the field with him to his quarterback. Everybody, it lightens everybody. We know the infamous two-step he had the O-line doing last week against Pittsburgh. Shit's a goddamn beauty. It's a goddamn beauty. And Joe Mixon's energy is irreplaceable. It's really the main reason I find him so important to this Bengals organization. So I hope as a fan base that we appreciate it while it's here, because we will miss it when it's not here anymore. For 5 years, even in down years when we was playing like dog dicky, it feels like Joe Mixon has found a way to get a few fans lit, and it's very needed for this new Rule the Jungle campaign vibe we're trying to build here in Cincinnati. And I'm not saying that he's the only one responsible or that he's the only spark in that regard, but we can't act like, especially in the last 2 weeks, that Joe Mixon has not lifted up this entire team, organization, fan base, everything in regards to energy and hype, the dances, the flexing on people, the everything, just the aura, everything about Joe Mixon as a running back has been the effort, the energy he brings in regards to playing hard, all of it. It's insane. And that energy in regards to playing hard leaks into the third and last thing. Well, not the last thing, but the last main thing, I'd say, because there's so many things I could say about Joe Mixon that make him so great for this team. But these are the three main things. It started with leadership. It goes into energy, and now effort. Effort in regards to his play. Mixon is the king of making 1 to 3 yard gains turn into 7 to 10 yard gains strictly off pure willpower and aggression. I mean, Joe Mixon is a grown ass man, and it's starting to show on a national scale even more now that the Bengals are winning along with it. When you're losing in a guy like that's playing so hard, it's going to be not recognizable. But now that we're winning and people get to see it on display, it's like, whoa, okay, where did Joe Mixon come from? He's been there. It's just no one realized because no one was watching the 2-14 or the 5-whatever Bengals. Now that we're winning and the nation, it's going to be very, very, very special to see Joe Mixon become what he's becoming. I believe he actually, in this recent week, not only did he, I know he had 165 yards his career high, but he also, just with yards after contact, would have beat the guy that was second behind him in yards. So he had so many yards after contact, 140-something, I think, something along the lines there. But Joe Mixon had an unbelievable last 2 weeks, and it's going to be great to see him the rest of the, not only this year, but the rest of his career. And hopefully it'll all be in Cincinnati, because he's the kind of kid, the kind of guy you love to see, you know, get drafted here and stay here his whole career, along with Burrow, along with Jamar, along with Higgins. These are all young guys that you can really build a whole entire team, or at least an entire offense around. And that's what we need, and that's what we have now. So let's appreciate it. Let's give Joe Mixon his flowers, goddammit. And I hope some of these highlights I'm showing you really do him justice in terms of the effort he gives, in terms of the energy he brings, and in terms of everything he's meant for this organization. Bengal Nation, make sure you guys subscribe below. Let me know what other content you guys want to see. I'll have the Chargers Bengals preview up in the next couple of days. Be on the lookout for that. Very, very, very hyped about that game. Extremely hyped. And Joe Mixon's going to have a lot to do with that game. So this video should be coming to y'all right at the right time. Go do more research on Joe. Go watch some interviews. Listen to him talk. He's a great, great, great guy for this team, and he cares about Cincinnati. He cares about the city. He cares about the team, and those are the guys we need. And when you have those three things, leadership, energy, and effort, what more do you want out of a guy except for talent? And Joe Mixon, trust me, he is not devoid of talent whatsoever. Dude has maximum talent. He could, and this is what I want to end the video off with. Could Joe Mixon become the best running back in football? He's hitting his prime right now, I'd say, ladies and gentlemen. And if it's not, if not Jonathan Taylor or Derrick Henry, he might just definitely be the best in the AFC. He might just. Let me know y'all's thoughts about Joe Mixon below. Of course, we want him to stick around forever here in Cincinnati. If you don't, then I don't know what to tell you. But I know running backs will fall off eventually, and when he does, hopefully he'll stay on the bench and he won't go to no other team to go find a Super Bowl. He won't GO us or anything of that nature. GO didn't really GO us. It's not like, you know, it was completely in his control at all. But goddamn it, I wanted to see GO stay a Bengal. No, I'm just playing. I don't really give a damn about Joe Bernard. I give a damn about my guy, Joe Mixon. Stick around, Joe. We love you. Hootay Nation, we out. Deuces.